It's not as heavy as it looks. It is now my pleasure to present a second APA award for lifetime contributions to psychology to an equally worthy recipient, Dr. James M. Jones. James Jones is a professor of psychology at the University of Delaware. He was also the director of APA's Minority Fellowship Program. And I have to tell you, as one of the first recipients in the fellowship, I have benefited from the process of socialization into the APA, which first Dr. Delmas Taylor and then Dr. James Jones provided to fellow recipients. So here I am. Dr. Jones' main area of interest is UCR, or the Universal Context of Racism. A second area of work explores the implications of TRIOs, a psychological worldview that combines African-inspired processes of time, rhythm, improvisation, orality, and spirituality. Dr. Jones is also interested in the social psychology of time. Dr. Jones, I would like to read highlights from your award. As director of the APA Minority Fellowship Program for nearly 30 years, you were inspirational to our field and an exemplar of dedicated service. You have contributed to the program's renown as one of the most successful for ethnic and racial minority researchers and service providers in the history of federally funded programs. Your integrity, cultural sensitivity, foresight, and strong leadership have enriched the education and training of generations of racial and ethnic minority psychologists. Through the Minority Fellowship Program, you secured millions of dollars of federal grant money. Moreover, you have been a major author and researcher in the area of prejudice and discrimination. Congratulations, Dr. Jones.
A little bit too eager to get my prize. Thank you very much, Dr. J.T., Melba J.T. Vasquez, Melba. It's very special to share the stage tonight with the CEO, the president, the keynote speaker, and my other honoree, because it reflects, I think, a very important exemplification of how diversity in psychology makes us a better discipline and a better field of study. I'm especially happy to share this evening with my beloved family. They're waiting for this. My wife, Olive, who has always encouraged me, supported me, and loved me for every one of these lifetime years. My daughters, Shelley Hairston Jones, and her husband, Keith, and their son, my grandson, Lowell James Hairston, who is a handsome, precious, fearsome lacrosse playing grandson and bike riding buddy. Nashi Jones Cantrell, my other daughter, and her husband Maurice, who's sort of takes care of the family organization. She works for Microsoft and she knows how to do all that stuff. I'm very happy to be able to share this with them. There are many people who I want to thank. I can't thank them all, obviously, by name, but I do want to just mention my mentors, Norm Henderson, who was my mentor at Oberlin College, Tom Shipley at Temple, and at Yale, Bob Abelson and Chuck Kiesler, and Chuck is the one who brought me to APA. They taught me how to think rigorously about psychology, and it's been my approach to everything I've done ever since. The Minority Fellowship Program family, beginning with Dalmas Taylor, who's deceased now, but who set the model for the program, the fellows, who of course are the heart of it, the advisory committee to help us make it work, and the many colleagues in departments of psychology around the country, going back to 1975, 76, when departments were very different than they are now. At least they were certainly a different color. They support us unfailingly and generously, and I really appreciate that. My colleagues at APA, who over 28 years of being there, really supported what we did and how we approached things. When I applied for PhD programs in 1965, I did so because I wanted to be Kenneth B. Clark. I did. I had read an article in the New York Times about his work, the How You Act work in Harlem, and I thought, if I got a PhD, maybe I could do something significant like that. So I went to study experimental social psychology and surprisingly learned from my colleagues that, one, race was not an experimental variable in social psychology, and two, our science was more interested in variables than in people. Neither of these views would stand up today, but that was the climate in which I launched my career as a social psychologist. I was given an opportunity to write about race, which I did in Prejudice and Racism in 1972, and I wanted to talk about race from my own personal black experience and explore the core, which in my mind was culture. I introduced the concept of cultural racism that identified the intersection of power, racialized beliefs and antipathies, systemic institutional practices, and their impact on social inequality and injustice. The second volume of Prejudice and Racism showed that, in 1997, showed that how much more we knew about racism, but how little we knew about how to diminish it. And further showed that diversity in the U.S. population was presenting new challenges that an evolving psychology was increasingly challenged to address. I came to APA in 1977, and over the period of some 28 years, we supported nearly 1,500 doctoral students who've earned their degrees in psychology. Many of them are here, not only Melba, Shell Grills, president of ABSci, Fred Leong. I mean, I can't begin to try to name everybody, but really significant figures in psychology who reflect, I think, well on what we tried to do. In 1975, 5.4% of PhDs in psychology were awarded to ethnic and racial minorities. In 2008, that number was 23.7. That's a significant increase. They weren't all recipients of the APA Minority Fellowship, but I think the spirit of the fellowship resided in all of them. In 1981, ethnic and racial minority faculty were around 5%, and in 2010, they were 15% in departments of psychology. Again, a significant increase, not enough, but really significant. And among the APA membership, just since 1987, it has doubled from 5 to 10%. These are not overwhelming numbers, but they do suggest that sustained effort can really make a difference. I served as the first executive director for public interest, during which we published articles on abortion in the journal Science, which I think was very significant and pivotal. We did special issues of the American Psychologist on homelessness and HIV and AIDS. And our aim was to bring psychological science to bear on public interest issues and to help shape social policy along the way, and I think we did a pretty good job. Over the past 40 years, I have seen significant changes in the nature of psychology. I always argued that diversifying psychology in this way would not only provide opportunities for those who had little, but would ultimately make psychology a better discipline. I have no doubt that both are true. Woody Allen says, 95% of life is just showing up. I've been showing up for what has become a lifetime, and I'm truly honored to be recognized for whatever role I have played in making psychology a better discipline, a more inclusive discipline, and one that matters in our society. Thank you, Madam President, for this great, great honor.